Hello, photopillars! Rafael the Bar here. Let's talk about zodiacal light. In this video, we're gonna see what the zodiacal light is, when and where to see it, and how to photograph it step by step, including all the gear you need and all the camera settings you need. Ready? This is gonna be fun. What is the zodiacal light? The zodiacal light is a cone of dim light, of eerie light, that appears at the horizon before dawn and after dusk. It is comparable in brightness to the Milky Way, but even milkier in appearance. Well, this rare astronomical event is the result of the reflections produced by the scattering of sunlight due to particles moving along the entire solar system. Unfortunately, this phenomenon is only visible in a certain number of months. But the good news is that when it's visible in both northern and southern hemisphere. But tell me, have you seen it? Have you photographed it? Let me know in the comments. So, when and where the zodiacal light is visible? Well, you can enjoy this natural phenomenon in spring and autumn, no matter where you live. In both hemispheres, spring is the best time to see it in the evening, after dusk, in the west, in the sunset direction. And in autumn is the best time to see it in the morning, before dawn, in the east, in the sunrise direction. 1 hour or so before dawn. Of course, you need to take into account that spring and autumn happen in different months in each hemisphere. Okay, knowing when and where the zodiacal light is visible is great, but if you wish to plan your zodiacal light photos with precision, this is to find the right shooting spot, the right shooting date and time, and the right shooting direction for the best photo possible. Do this. How to plan the zodiacal light? It's super, super easy. First, find a dark sky location with an interesting subject to use it in your composition with the zodiacal light. For example, imagine that you're in the beautiful island of Menorca in the northern hemisphere, and you wish to plan a cool photo of the zodiacal light with this cool stone construction. Cool, let's see how to do it. Just go to PhotoPills and use the PhotoPills planner to plan the shot. As always, the first thing you need to do is to place this red pin you see on the mat next to your subject. In this case, next to this amazing stone hut. Second, set the day you want to photograph the zodiacal light. As you now know, in the northern hemisphere, in spring, March, April, May, the zodiacal light is visible in the west, after dusk, in the sunset direction. So let's say that you want to photograph the zodiacal light in March. What day should you choose? Well, you'll need a dark sky, so it's much better if there is no moon. So let's set the date of the March new moon. The fastest way to do it is to double tap on the time bar to set the date to today and now. And now tap on the moon icon you see on the top panel until you get to the next new moon, which happens on March 13th. The truth is that you don't really need to plan your zodiacal shots for the new moon. All you need is the moon to be below the horizon. So the week before and after new moon work great too. Just make sure that the moon is below the horizon at the time of the shooting. Okay, we've set the date, and now the orange thick line you see on the map is telling me the direction of the sunset, the direction where the zodiacal light will be visible. So I can use this sunset line to compose my shot. For example, if I want the zodiacal light to be next to my hut, I could move my red pin here, and from this spot, well, I would have my subject, the stone hut, and in the north, the zodiacal light, which is pretty cool. As you see, planning the shot is so easy. Now I have my shooting spot, the red pin position, my shooting date, this is March 13th, the new moon date. Next step is to figure out the shooting time. Now the question is, at what time should I start shooting? Well, you'll find the answer in panel number 5. So swipe the top panel to the left until you get to this panel, the twilight panels, and here you can read the time the astronomical twilight ends in the evening at 8:20 p.m. It's when the night time begins. So summing up, if on March 13th I am at the red pin position at 8:20 p.m. I'll see the zodiacal light next to my stone hut, which makes a great shot. And if the weather doesn't cooperate on that specific date, I'm not worried at all, because I can shoot the same shot, you know, the week before and after that date. So all I'll have to do is to have an eye at the weather forecast and pick the best night. Okay, now that we have the plan, let's see the gear we need to photograph the zodiacal light. To photograph the zodiacal light, you'll use the same equipment you use to photograph the Milky Way. By the way, if you wish to learn how to photograph the Milky Way, watch this video. Long story short, you'll need your camera. The better the noise performance of your camera at high ISO, the better results you'll get. You also need a wide-angle lens to capture both the foreground, your subject, and the zodiacal light and the sky. Then you'll need a sturdy tripod and head and a short release or an intervalometer. Remember that you'll be shooting a long exposure, so the less you touch the camera, the more stable the system is, the better. You need to avoid vibrations at all costs, because vibrations produce blurry images. And if you're getting a too dark foreground, then you can use one or two LED panels, LED panels, to add light from the side, so you capture beautiful foreground with volume and texture. And if you light paint the foreground, I recommend you to use the low level lighting technique I explain in tip number 6 of this video. Watch it. And last but not least, if there is light pollution, then you can use a light pollution filter, like for example the Pure Night filter by my friend Ian Norman. Actually, I'm gonna leave in the description of this video the link to this Pure Night filter and also to all the gear Anthony Clotaire, the photographer of the Photopills team, uses to photograph the night sky. Check it out. Okay, let's talk about camera settings. Focal length. Use a short focal length to capture the foreground and a big portion of the sky. For example, a 14mm focal length works great. Aperture. Set a wide aperture, like for example f2.8, because you need as much light as possible to reach the sensor. Exposure time. As it happens with the Milky Way photography, you'll need to shoot a long exposure, but not too long, because you want to capture the zodiacal light and also pinpoint the stars, not trails. And you know that due to the rotation of the Earth, after a certain exposure time, the stars will begin to appear as trails in the photo, not points. So what exposure time do you need to use? Well, usually shutter speed exposure time between 10 to 20 seconds will work. But if you want to calculate it with precision, you can go to Photopills in the Pills menu and use the Spot Stars calculator to calculate it in a few seconds. And here you have a video where I explain how to use this calculator to work out the exposure time you need when you're photographing the Milky Way. If you're interested, you have it here. Watch it. ISO. Push the ISO up to 1600, 3200, depending on your camera. Push the ISO up to catch a powerful zodiacal light and also as many stars as possible. Focusing. If you've been following us for a while, you know that we, the Photopills team, we always focus at the hyperfocal distance because it allows us to maximize depth of field. This means that it allows us to have the subject, the foreground, in focus and also the stars in focus. And it's super easy and super convenient. We use it all the time. And if you wish to understand hyperfocal distance, how to calculate it and how to use it to focus to maximize depth of field, watch this video. Well, this is the focusing technique we use. But what about you? What focusing technique do you use to photograph the Milky Way or the zodiacal light? Let me know in the comments. Great, once you've made focus, take a test shot and check that everything looks great. Check the histogram, that the exposure looks great, and also check if you're getting the depth of field you want in the photo. If you're getting the result you want, great, you're ready to go. And if you're not getting the result you want, just make adjustments to improve your exposure time or your depth of field. And keep adjusting until you get the photo you want. Fantastic, fantastic, fantastic. The zodiacal light is an amazing phenomenon to photograph, but there are many, many more cool events approaching. If you wish to have the whole list of astronomical events to photograph, I'm gonna leave a link in the description of this video to our super detailed astronomical events photography guide. Check it out. And tell me, what's your favorite astronomical event? Leave a comment below. The next video is gonna be about another cool phenomenon to photograph. So give me a like, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. And remember that you have the power to imagine, plan, and shoot legendary photos. Bye.